Alright guys, here it is. This is the Taramps DS800x4. Now this is the 2 ohm version, right? So that means it's 2 ohm stable. Focus. Camera has Tourette syndrome here. So, see it says 2 ohms, 2 ohms stereo, 4 ohms bridged. Okay? This is the side. I do not like how they did this. I wish it had the standard plug in for the power and the ground. And I can see where I kind of chart it right there. So this is the goofy thing with the Taramps. Positive, negative. So this is what kind of tripped me up. It's like, if you run it here, it's 2 ohms. Here is 2 ohms, but then you bridge it, it's 4 ohms. But you get the most power out of the amp at 2 ohms. So, at 2 ohms, if you run all 4 channels, it says you get 136 watts times 4. Or excuse me, at 4 ohms, you get 136 watts times 4. Now, if you run it at 2 ohms, you get the full 200 watts by all 4 channels. It's kind of weird the way they have this wired, but so far I like it. I got some, I'm going to rewire this. I'll show you guys what I'm going to do here. The back, it's got the standard 4 RCA plugs. It's got your high pass, low pass main, and it has the gains. But on Taramps, people call them the volume, which is kind of funny. It's a very small amp, as you can see the size of my hand here. Let's see if I can find a tape measure. We got about, including the terminals, about 8.5. And she's about, I don't know, 2.25. 2 inches high. What did I say? Yeah, 8.5 long. And it's about six and a half wide. It's a good little amp, guys. I've had it for a couple months. I got it back in December. Now, what's really odd about the Taramps, first off, you can see I taped up right here. Because when you're putting in wires and you accidentally touch metal on metal, I've sparked it a couple times. I don't know if you can see that right here. I'll put another little clip in where you can see it better. But anyways, I don't like this amp just because there's no standard plugins like this. You have to use a stupid spade connector, which I cannot stand. So I was sick of messing with this in the truck and worrying about wires sparking off. So what I did, I wired up everything the way I wanted, 2 ohms. Then I put all the female connectors on here. And then in my truck, I got the male connectors. So I'm always pulling amps in and out of the truck. So I figured this would just be the quickest way. Connect it, male, female, male, female, male, female. You're done. You can't really mess it up. Pretty easy, guys. And I'm also going to redo my power and maybe my ground too. I got these little copper lugs here. I'm gonna take my Dremel. I'm gonna cut it down just enough so half of it fits in there. And this can go to my wire. Because I actually have 0 gauge. But I have to trim it way down to fit these because this is 4 gauge adapters. And of course, if you want to see what a 0 gauge looks like, 0 gauge is the size of almost all 3 terminals. So 0 gauge does not fit this, unfortunately. What else here? Even my smaller or my larger forks, guys, doesn't fit. I mean, you could probably squish it in there, but it doesn't fit naturally. That's how small these are. The spade connectors I use on these are the 18 to 22 gauge, so they're really small. I have 16 gauge wire running to it, or the 14 gauge wire, yeah. All right, let's get to trimming, guys. Let's trim this up a little bit and see if I can get this thing to fit in there. Pause the video here and I'll come back and let you know when I'm done. All right, guys, bear with me. I'm in the truck. It is 14 below zero outside right now, so I'm trying to do this without freezing my balls off. So you saw all my wires wired up here. So I run everything 2 ohms to the female connectors. I pre-wired my power in, and I'm just going to power it into my other power wire I have down there. The ground is good, and then of course the remote's no issue because the remote's just a tiny little wire usually. So for future references, I have the tape here so I won't spark it anymore. I'm pretty excited to see how this sounds, guys, so I'm going to plug it all in and we'll come back and we'll see how it sounds.
Who says you can't do car audio when it's 10 below zero outside? All right, got the new 6x9 put in here. Got the amp all wired up. I even put my last couple pieces of sound deadener on here. I got a couple on the inside of the door panel. All I gotta do is heat it up a little bit. And this stuff gets really sticky, almost like tar, and it goes right in the grooves, no problem. Good old Milwaukee heat gun to the rescue. Move the heater over a little bit. Don't melt the goddamn speaker. And that is how you put in a speaker when it's 5 or 10 below 0 out, however cold it is. All right, I got all the speakers hooked up. I got all 8 speakers hooked up. You guys hear that? We're over here at this big empty parking lot. All right, it's about 25 feet or so. That sounds pretty effing good. 112, 1600 watt, 12 inch sub, 4 6x9s, 2 6 inches, and 2 3.5 tweets. And I have the bass on -5.